Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Leah Cheshier. There's no denying the effects of the coronavirus around the world, but there are three people in space aware of those effects too. This week, NASA astronaut Andrew Morgan shared what it's like being on the space station while we navigate life during a pandemic.
Well, certainly with my own family, I'm in touch with them every day, and I know all the measures that have been taken to help prevent the spread of it. And I don't have concerns. I know my family is safe. But in terms of NASA and our support on the ground, NASA and our partner agencies, the partner space agencies, are no strangers to working during times of adversity. Just as recently as a couple years ago, when Houston was basically shut down by Hurricane Harvey, Mission Control Houston endured right through it. Operations up here are going to continue regardless of what's happening on the ground, and the resolve of the controllers on the ground have persevered, and I know that they'll continue to do that. The difference this time is that there is some impact to all the control centers all over the world, but we're showing right now that they show the same resolve to make sure that the ISS remains safe, and so we have full confidence in those that support us on the ground.
The vacuum of space may be silent, but the inside of the space station is definitely not. Due to constantly running machinery, the space station can be a pretty noisy environment, and it doesn't help that fluid shifts might cause pressure anomalies in the inner ear. The acoustic diagnostic study monitors effects of the microgravity and acoustic environment aboard the space station in efforts to detect and quantify early symptoms of mild hearing impairment. Researchers are using autoacoustic emissions-based tests to obtain fast results through a non-invasive diagnosis process for crew members. These tests occur before, during, and after an astronaut's mission to determine any possible adverse effects. This helps us prepare for long-duration missions to the Moon and Mars and increased exposure to noisy environments. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.